फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल माय टीएसपीएससी प्रिपरेशन। दिस इज़ अवर फर्स्ट डे। वी आर स्टार्टिंग फॉर द हिस्ट्री ऑफ तेलंगाना एंड इन दिस वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द सेंचुरीज बिटवीन 6 to 4 BC। सो व्हाई दिस सेंचुरी 6 to 4 BC इज प्रोमिनेंट, व्हाई आर वी स्टार्टिंग बिटवीन दिस फ्रॉम दिस पीरियड इज ड्यूरिंग दिस पीरियड religions like Jainism and Buddhism, they have flourished, which means they have come into existence, or the founding of the Jainism has been taken place, Jainism and Buddhism. And with the text available by Buddhists and Jainism, we are understanding how the political conditions and how the kingdoms were there during that time. So there is a Buddhist text called Anguttara Nikaya. So with this Buddhist text, we understand the political conditions of that period. There is also a Jain text called Bhagavati, as you can see in the slide. So these two books are the main sources for gaining our knowledge in 6th century BC. So in this book, Buddhist text Anguttara Nikaya, we have 16 Janapadas. Like this book has mentioned about 16 Janapadas. Now what does the term Janapadas means? So this is a Sanskrit word basically. Jana means people. Padas means the footsteps. So overall Janapadas means the people who were available at that time. Like in a religion, they have been there. In a region, they have been there. Not religion, it's region. In region, they have been there, and their existence, it has been penned in this Janapada. One of such Janapadas is Asmaka Janapada, which is our main focus of today's understanding. So there is a Janapada called Asmaka Janapada, one of those 16 Janapadas. And since I told Janapada is the territory of certain people staying in that area, and so we need to understand the boundaries of this territory. It is expanded between our Telangana's Nizamabad till Maharashtra's Nanded district. So between this boundaries, there is this territory called Asmaka Janapada. The kingdom which also flourished for the very first time was the Asmaka Janapada. So that's why we are giving more importance to the Asmaka Janapada. So let's understand the capital of this Janapada. So the capital was Pothan. Now where Pothan is the question you might get. So basically this Pothan is today's Budhan region. This is the capital of Asmaka Janapada, which is there in Nizamabad, which is today's Budhan. It is termed as Budhan. Other than this, we also have the kingdoms like Mulaka, Asmaka, Kalinga, Battiprolu, Andhra and Andhaka kingdoms. So these kingdoms are also there, but we are going to discuss about Mulaka, Asmaka, Andhaka and Andhra kingdoms. We will discuss all the kingdoms one after the other. Let me tell you guys a story now. This is during the time of Sri Krishna. There was a devil called Potana who tried to kill Sri Krishna during his childhood. And since that, with that name Potana, we got this capital Pothan. Asmaka kingdom is a non-Aryan kingdom. Why I am saying non-Aryan kingdom is, Aryan people are people who are coming from north. Those are called as Aryan people. And like you see the name Asmaka, it is already sounding like south. So that's why it's a non-Aryan kingdom. So Aryan people, they might have taken it from the descendants of Potana. That's why it could have got the name like Pothan, which got transformed to Budhan, today's Budhan. There is some religious text which also says, it's a Jain religious text, and When I'm saying Jain religion text, we should also be knowing who is the founder of Jainism. It was Rishabhanatha. Please remember, it is Rishabhanatha. Rishabhanatha, with his younger son, Bahubali. Bahubali inherited Asmaka Janapada and then ruled with Podhana or Podhanyapur as its capital, which is today's Bodhan. Bahubali, which I mentioned, is the same Bahubali whose statue is present in Gomateshwara statue, which is at Shravanabelagola. So he is the same person, Bahubali. So there are a few beautiful stories with connection to this. Let me tell you one of these stories. So there was a Ikshvaku prince called Asmaka. He occupied the region and that's how the name Asmaka has come into picture. But regarding Asmaka, how he got the name is, his one of the ancestors, like his mother, when she was pregnant and when she was 7 months pregnant actually, there was a guru called Vashishta. That guru helped his mother to make the pregnancy possible with an instrument called Asmaka. That's how he got the name Asmaka. During the time of Asmaka, there was another great king called Parashurama. You can tell Parashurama was a contemporary of Asmaka. Contemporary means from the same era. Like if it is 100 BC, he is also from 100 BC. Same era. He was the contemporary. So that's how we term the name contemporary. So Parashurama attacked his kingdom, who is Asmaka's kingdom. And at that time, Asmaka's son, his name is Mulaka. He fled away at that time. And he fled away to a new place and he made his kingdom named Mulaka kingdom after his name. And the capital for his kingdom, he put it as Pratishthanpur. Please note Pratishthanpur. Pratishthanpur is important and I told Bodhan is capital for Asmaka kingdom. These two kingdoms, which one? The Asmaka and the Mulaka, are called as Andhra kingdoms. The proof for this kingdoms to be named as Andhra kingdom is a plaque-like structure was found at Nagpur. A dome near Nagpur. It also says that a war happened between Kalingas and Asmakas actually. According to the Puranas, there was a king called Mahapadmananda. He completely rooted out the Kshatriya caste. We know, right, we have four castes: Brahmins, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas, Sutras. Brahmins, who are the devotees. Kshatriyas are the kings. So he completely rooted out the Kshatriyas caste and he called himself Ugrasena and Parashurama too. And since Asmaka and Mulaka kingdoms were ruled by the Kshatriyas, Mahapadmananda invaded these and he rooted out these two dynasties. And then he named those dynasties, or he named his empire as Nanda Empire. How you can remember Nanda Empire is with Lord Shri Krishna. You can relate this to Lord Shri Krishna. Shri Krishna's father's name is Nand. So that's why Shri Krishna is also called Nand Kishore, right? So you can remember in that way. Nanda Empire was established in 4th century BC. After Nanda's period, it was Mauryan Empire. And after Maurya, Shatavahanas took over this region. And during this Mauryan Empire, like after the end of Nanda period, they ruled. Mauryan people ruled for around 200 years. Few of the famous kings you can name is Ashok, Chandragupta Maurya. So these are few famous names that comes into mind while we are talking about Mauryan Empire. Tomorrow we will talk about Andhra Rettam kingdom. How this kingdom was formed? What is the Buddhist text which was been added as a base to this? Now let us look into our bits. First question. How many Janapadas were there in India according to the ancient Buddhist text Anguttara Nikaya? The answer is 16 Janapadas. Second, the name of the kingdom that spread in the Nizamabad district region of Telangana and Nanded region of Maharashtra, which was one of the 16 Janapadas. So this is Asmaka kingdom spread between Nizamabad and Maharashtra. Next, according to Jain text, a king ruled the Asmaka region with Puthan or Paudanyapuram as his capital during the period of Rigveda. What is the name of that king? It is Bahubali. Bahubali is the son of Rishabhanatha. Rishabhanatha is the founder of Jainism. Third question. Capital of Asmaka kingdom, which was stated as one of the 16 Janapadas. It is Puthan or Paudanyapuram or Patiya or Bodhan, which is present in Nizamabad. Fourth question. Where was a plague in which the name of Asmaka Janapada was mentioned? Found recently. It is Adome near Nagpur. What is a plague? Plague is a metal sort of, it is a metal on which inscriptions are written. That you can term it as a plague. Let's look at the objective side. First question. Which Janapada was mentioned on the ancient plague found recently at the Adome region near Nagpur? You have options Kamboja, Panchali, Avanti, Asmaka. So the correct answer is Asmaka. With this, I end my video. Please keep learning and stay updated. Thank you.